I hate it when she goes, but I worry about her. But I'm so proud of her coming back and doing this training for Ironman again. And she makes me better every day watching her. I mean, you couldn't ask for anything better than a companion in life. I mean, watching her attack out her job and our family and her training, it's just so amazing to watch. It's really inspiring, right in my own house. She makes me so proud.
I'm a food addict, and in my life, my addiction to food has led me to be obese. I was over 100 pounds heavier than I am now, and I still struggle in it every day. I used to tell people all the time that I don't have a shut-off button. I don't ever feel like I'm full. Till to this day, and it's a struggle every day. It's like alcohol. I hear people tell this all the time, and it makes sense. It's like it's rather be an alcoholic than a food addict, because alcohol you can quit and live without. Food you cannot. You need it in your life. So it's scary. It's scary every day. It's every day that you have to grind. It's literally day by day. It can go so south. I won't end up in a ditch passed out, like alcohol might do to you, but it leads to some really bad thoughts in my head, and it's always going to be a struggle for me. So I know a lot of people, and a lot of people have come and talked to me, that still have that struggles, and it's tough. It's tough. It'll probably never change. It'll probably never be different. But what we can do is kind of find those things that small processes every day, from meditation to preparing your meals, and start cooking and not eating out and cutting some of those things out. Because I think if we do that, cut some of those bad things out and try to stay on that path, the more we do that and more we become routine, I think it settles in a little bit. Yeah, you'll have kickbacks, you'll have lapses. But the important thing is that it's just that day. Just that hour, just that 15 minutes, that you know that doesn't define you or doesn't define me. That it's about the power of change.
So, you know, I've been plant-based now for a couple years, so it's completely vegan. Off and on for the last probably 5 years, off and on. But I actually got a tick allergy called alpha-gal. It makes me allergic to red meat. And I found that out the hard way from eating red meat for you. I found passion in this. I found my buddy Scott Spitz, listening to Rich Roll, all those people kind of gave me that information. Friends with Shauna at Wheatgrass. So fine, it fits what I believe in, and being conscious of the earth and what I want to put my feet on, and mountains and all of that. That's part of that universe. It's been really good. Cheers. Oh man, it's good. All right, heading out for a little run. I'm gonna try to do a little bit of a test where I am heart rate wise. So I'm gonna go probably about 140 heart rate, see where I am, see what the pace goes to. It's a good indicator for me. All right, it's a pretty good run. Under 140 beats is kind of my go-to test. And so, you know, fastest of that was 8:10 mile, the average about 8:45. So that's good, getting back closer to where I was before after 100 mile training into Ironman. So excited about that. Progress, right? Especially on a hot day like this, you gotta factor that in. So, I'm very pumped. What are you guys doing?
Daddy!
What?
You're recording us.
That garbage onto the police.
Really?
Yeah, and there's like the blue truck. Oh, there's the eye catcher. Cause the police cars can also zoom over this one. Woo-hoo. I got there. And there's the.
so good. And there's a woman in the kitchen cleaning up the evening slime. And he looks at her and says, "Hey, darling, I can remember when you could stop a cloud. Oh, but ain't that America? You and me, ain't that America? Something to see, baby, ain't that America? Home of the free."
Hey, good luck to all 10 milers, Mohicans, Bourbon Bluegrass runs today. Gonna be awesome. Alright, peace. You know what the greatest thing about running is that you can find trails anywhere. You go on Strava, look it up, you find where the runners go. It's like dogs, they just pee everywhere. If you mark their territory, go where the Strava is. Good running. Found some great trails like this. Like, yeah, crazy, right? That's in the middle of just nowhere, running on streets, and that pops up. Super cool. Thanks, Missouri. Good run.
It's amazing.
So when you walk into a Bash Pro Shop and you got a vegan shirt, a flat bill cap, shaved legs, and Chacos on, you get a lot of stares, especially from the Donald Trump hat guy. Yeah, I may look like that, but I got the